Hi students, today we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is renal glycosuria. You know, I've already covered this topic once when we were discussing Benedict's test, that is test for reducing substances by which we detect glycosuria, right? Now, renal glycosuria can be given as a case, as a chart, anything, right? As an OGTT chart, that is oral glucose tolerance test chart, anything, right? The key point is this is not simple glycosuria. We use the term renal glycosuria. Remember, in normal glycosuria, blood glucose level needs to be very high. It needs to be above 180 milligram per deciliter. That is the renal threshold. This is the renal threshold level. But it means whenever glucose crosses this value, kidneys fail to reabsorb. Below this, kidneys always is excellent, capable of reabsorbing glucose, and no glucose will come out in urine. There will be no glycosuria. But in rare cases, when there is mutation in GLUT2 receptors, mainly that is the reason, kidneys fail to reabsorb glucose even if glucose volume is below this 180 mg per deciliter. So what can it mean? It means even if glucose is 120 milligram per deciliter, there will be glycosuria, which is not normal, right? Normally we get glycosuria when glucose is above 180 in diabetes mellitus, right? In case of extreme hyperglycemia. But even if patient is non-diabetic, patient is normoglycemic, even if we will have glycosuria. So the reason why it occurs, I told you, and the disease why it occurs is known as Fanconi-Bickel syndrome. Very important. It may rarely happen in pregnancy or acute glomerulonephritis, but those shouldn't be the reasons that to mention first. First should be Fanconi-Bickel syndrome. Reason is failure of reabsorption of glucose due to mutation in GLUT2 receptors. And how it will be given as a chart? In chart, there will be given patient is non-diabetic. Very important. Glucose level will be absolutely normal, but Benedict's test will be positive. Either one, or they will give an OGTT value where there will be plotting of glucose curve, but the glucose curve will be absolutely normal. But in urine, they will show plus plus sign. It means in urine, there is glycosuria, right? So anything, remember, first look at the glucose value. If glucose value is normal, but there is glycosuria, it means renal glycosuria. Alternative diagnosis can happen if they just say Benedict's test is positive. Remember, Benedict's test may be positive even if there is no glycosuria. So blood glucose normal, but Benedict's test positive can happen in case of ascorbic acid in urine or homocysteine acid in urine. So alkaptonuria may be a diagnosis. But whenever they say glucose in urine and normal blood glucose level, it should always be a diagnosis of renal glycosuria due to Fanconi-Bickel syndrome. That's it for today. Feel free to get back to me in the comment section. I will see you with another video. Till then, bye and take care, and thanks for watching.